there's wetlands down there at the heads of the tidal flats. Excellent.
Did you see how far the mucus could make it up the slope? Mucus? Zostera, I mean. So the zostera
limit there, and we've got wetlands, fringing wetlands around the margins.
There's some eagle tracks.
The sand flat. Pebbly sand beach face, and then a flat down low with lots of zostera on it.
Patchy fucus and lots of large laminarins in the lower. There's also macrocystis out of the water. On the point there, it looks a little different than the laminarins. Different color.
And back onto the main shoreline here, where the boulder cobble veneer.
There's an alba on the
pebble sand
beach there in 35.
Now we're back into
large
our sand flat where
our
broke off.
Bit left.
We've done this. This island ahead of us here, Mark, that long skinny one, sort of right here. Yeah. So the sand drapes in the lower to tidal and lots of the shoreline, pull the cobble up
there.
High.
37.
There's some of our drift logs that have been stranded offshore. That's a big cedar.
Lots of
pebble cobble up high and then sand in the lower half of the intertidal. Good example of that. That Tombolo there is a pebbly sand in between these two little bedrock islands. Good overview of the islands and the morphology. And we've got bedrock ramp shorelines with cobble boulder veneer, sand in the lower intertidal on some of these flats. There's another bedrock island.
There's soft browns, which are the large blade laminarins.
Little tiny islets here. And this next one we're going to crab over to is
45, number one.
Got a village site on it, lots of good material evident, big tidal complex. And there would be very strong currents through the channel here. So this would be probably pretty really productive site. And that's the village site. And incredibly productive flat. You can see the large accumulations of bivalve shells on the flats.
Still out of the water.
This looks like possibly another older midden site on this side of the island, much more protected sand flat down below. It's a coarse sand on these beaches. And then there's another pebbly sand beach right down to the water line. And then we've got this large flat complex with a huge amount of shells on the flats.
Near shore there.
So those are bivalve shells on the flats, and then they're closing back on this village site there.
Macrocystis, really long lens.
those islands. That's good. No, I think we're done.
It's done.
Yeah.
See the water streaming in over there?
And we're half hour into the tape. We've got wetland, 2 or 3 meters, then boulder cobble, and then a tidal flat lower into tidal. Lots of accumulations of bivalve shells on that flat. There's wetland in up around that little tumbolo, then sand flats and things. And we've got a channel here. I'll probably, I can shoot in there, I guess.
Down
low, wetlands around the margins. You can probably see that.
Section sort of coming and going, but fairly continuous acrosystis in the near shore.
And back into a whole section of these flat bedrock complexes with boulder cobble veneers over the margins.
Eelgrass
and flats.
Lower flats between
the lower half of the intertidal zone, sort of as a sedimentary drape. We're flying over one of the.
Probably a village site on it, or a ceremonial site,
burial island, off to our left, just or right, just behind us.
Narrow and splash zone.
Then we're a whole complex
of things
in here, mostly
incredible macrosystems
in between the bedrock platforms.
Photo 5.